Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Field. Title of this video is You Must Listen For It. I talk to a lot of people on the phone and I get a sense that their listening and observation skill set is completely different than mine. There's some similarities, but there needs to be a broader range, a bigger scope of understanding. Critical listening is critical thinking first. You really have to start to think and understand what you're listening for. Because if you don't connect the auditory, the antenna, to the receiver, you know, the signal's not going to be good enough. So you have to think through for understanding of what you're doing here. And it's really important to do that because sometimes it's necessary to kind of break things down into parts and then if you look at each part like a car engine, you'll be able to see how the whole thing functions as a whole. I think that's important. You got to listen for that understanding too, after you get it, after you understand what sound and music and acoustics and all that is, then you have to kind of start listening for it. Can you hear that fundamental strike? Can you hear that snare hit? Can you hear the four orders of harmonics after it? Just pick one instrument and listen. Pick voice. We pick voice a lot in our theater because we have a video screen. We can see it. So we can see how long the artist is holding the note. And you can get the visual and the auditory going at the same time. They're helpful. Everything's got to stand alone, but work together at the same time. This is an understanding that you have to tune to. This is a good reason behind frequency response and balanced frequency response. You're not hearing too much of one thing or not enough of another, right? Use that RTA. It's a great tool. Have it on a screen right next to your listening position. You see something, you hear something, you see it on the screen, you're going to get a better understanding of everything. And that helps us all. More educated you are about the process, the better of a listener you're going to be. Singer, we talked about. Can the room support a strong attack in the low end? Can it take that 40 hertz? Can it take that 30 hertz? Can it resolve it? Hold it on just long enough that the tail can, the harmonics, you know, the 400, 80, 120, 60, 200, all the way up if you're doing 40. Can the room support those four orders of harmonics? And listen for that. It's real, real critical. And then roll it all together with the listening and the understanding, and does it sound like music? Are you tapping your foot? Another way to think about things. So it's important. You know, you must stop and listen for it, but you ought to understand what you're listening for. Hope this helps. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions and I usually get a chance every couple of days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.